Hello, my name is Lola. I'm going to react to old Thomas the Train, no, the Tank Engine on PS1, Caddicarus, featuring TomSka, whatever. This was recommended to me by JC. And if you want to like, comment, subscribe my channel, you can. If you don't want to, that's fine too. I just do some fun. Here we go.
Go to room 217. Thomas is waiting for you.
Can't you tell? I'm TomSka, the tank person.
Oh, right. Thomas is waiting for me.
I see. Ah, so you know of my good friend, Thomas the Train.
I don't think that's what he's called.
Turns out he's a big fan of your video, so he sent me here to give you a game he got stuck in his safety valve.
Well, I mean, if the great Thomas the Train wanted to give it to me, it must be good.
Oh, it is, but it's not here yet. Give it a sec.
What the hell is that on your head?
It's my short, stumpy funnel.
I need to stop asking questions.
You think that's cool? You should see my short, stumpy dome.
I'm leaving now.
No, wait! Don't go!
Why? I'm not picking that up.
You have to pick it up.
But it smells of poo.
Yeah.
Okay, did any of you guys know that Thomas the Tank Engine had a game on PS1 exclusive to Japan?
No.
Yeah, I knew.
It came out of a long hole on your head. I wasn't asking you.
Thomas the Tank Engine is a train. He's blue. He has a face. Thanks for coming to my seminar. I mean, come on, everyone knows who Thomas the Tank Engine is. He's bloody everywhere.
Oh, God. Yeah.
You cannot escape the tank. And that's quite an amazing achievement considering he's in a children's TV show where none of the train's faces ever actually move except for their eyes, almost like they're in some sort of coma. I watched Tom Tom the Tank Tank absolutely religiously as a kid, specifically the Ringo Starr narration era and early Michael Angelis era before he started phoning it in during the late 90s. But I could have done without the bullying around being born with the same name as the most unlikable character in the show. Thanks for that, guys. All of the Jameses of the world appreciate it.
Also, my girlfriend's eldest daughter had her own name for the show when she was a toddler. Thomas the Tankin' Dankin'.
Come on,
I just think that's funny.
The original run of the show from 1983 I still find to be very entertaining and charming kids' TV. It's relaxing, looks authentic and unique with the brilliant use of sculptures and models, and there's plenty of good moral lessons for the kids watching at home. Well, most of the time. The 1945 onwards books that the show was based on were written by a man known as the Reverend W. Audrey, and since the writing of these books, many have looked back at the original series and noticed some strong political undertones, such as the dismissal and threat against anything new for the steam trains like diesel fuel and air travel, and even subtext hinting at authoritarianism around the home of the trains on the island of Sodor, and it's not hard to see why. There are some outright dark and disturbing ideas around the economy of Sodor and how the workforce were treated if they didn't do their job perfectly in the eyes of the ruthless dictator that was the Fat Controller. In many ways, the trains were treated a little bit like slave labor, being forced to work whenever they were awake, being sold back and forth between different people to suit their needs, not being paid, and being punished in the most brutal methods possible for barely doing anything that bad to warrant it. A train goes a little bit too fast and comes off the rails a few times? Take off his wheels, turn him into a generator, and let him watch his friends enjoy their lives from behind a wall until he dies. What if a train gets too old and nobody wants to buy them? Don't give them a retirement package. Instead, just throw the living and breathing train with thoughts and feelings in the scrapyard. Or, you know, lock him up in a shed for about 10 years and let Mother Nature bury him alive. A train decides to stay in a tunnel for a little bit because he doesn't want to get wet from the rain. Brick him inside the tunnel and never let him out. Again, while being able to see all of his friends enjoying themselves as they chug along past him. This show was outright sadistic.
Wow, it's a lot darker than I
remember. Perfect for a kid's game on the PlayStation, right? Yes, this is indeed a real thing that exists. This is a 2000 Japanese exclusive PS1 game of our favourite Tankin Dankin. And it's called, roughly in English, Kid Station Kikansha Thomas Tanaka Matachi. I think. At least we definitely know it says Kids Station and not Babe Station. This game was lovingly donated to me by a guy at Too Many Games 2018 in Philadelphia, and I did write down the guy's name, but I later lost it. Sorry about that. I suppose that's a good thing, really, because if this game turns out to be completely horrible, you wouldn't want me to know your name.
All right, here we go. What does that say? Eh? What's this? Ban Pesto? Why would I want to do that? Oh, okay, no time for questions. It's time for an FMV intro. I mean, I've seen worse. It looks completely okay to me. You've got the classic theme tune. The characters are all here. It's a bit grainy and pixely, yeah, but it certainly looks like the show. Well, except for Thomas's face. A few years ago, a man jumped in front of Thomas, and he hasn't been the same since. Thomas, was that you? Oh god, now what the hell's going on? You're barely in the game for 5 seconds and the babies this game was meant for are thrown into a random slideshow in case they didn't hit start the moment they begin the game. Yeah, I'm just gonna skip this, there's nothing really going on here, and would you look at that? We're at the station, ready to hopefully play some kind of game. As you can see, we're in Napford.
Because that's where all the children get kidnapped for.
And all I know about Japanese PS1 games is that the circle button is actually used as a confirmation button instead of the X button, which we're all used to in the filthy West. So, I mean, I don't know what the piss any of this mean, so how about we just hit circle and see what happens? Did I do a thing? Was the thing good? You know, I'm honestly starting to prefer this over Ringo's voice.
What are you doing here? Can't you see?
Okay, well, even though I have absolutely no clue what is being yelled at me or what any of this means, what I do know is that I need to find the correct symbol by hitting the button that comes out of Thomas's funnel. And that's it.
Oh, thank you, sir, said Thomas.
Back at the menu, okay, we've seen what happens if I press circle, so what about if I hit square? Oh, well, we get this lovely image of James here. James murdered my dog! We also get to see the fat controller a little more clearly, and there he is. Looking bloody horrendous. What else is going on in the station, though? Let's have a look. Well, we have this guy over here licking a poster of Duck, but his head is covering the U, so it looks like
Johnson.
We also have this guy over here who's doing a m'lady to the kid down here, and this guy here who's, I don't know what he's doing. Anyway, let's click on James, because that is me. Ah, right, okay, so we count the people and hit the button with the correct number next to it. And that's it. We're done. This game is hard. Let's hit the square button again and see where we end up. Oh lord, oh dear, there's a fat controller option. I can't wait to see what that has in store for us. But first, I just have to bring your attention to this man hiding behind James. What is going on there? Anyway, the fat controller minigame takes us to his office. Yes, sorry, he's not called that everywhere else other than the UK, is he?
Sir Topham Hat.
The fat controller.
Sir Topham Hat.
The fat controller.
Sorry, the Sir Topham Hat minigame takes us to his office. And he's in a bit of a pickle because despite being the director of every train on the island of Sodor, he's forgotten what his main train looks like. We pick the correct one, Sir Topham Hat does a little... And then we get a lovely image of Percy being crushed by a boulder. What else can we click on this screen then? Oh! Clock! The clock itself is a character, now I've seen everything. We have to pick the correct time with the buttons, but I can't read what the hell the fat controller is asking me, so I'm just gonna have to guess. What? Yes! I got it right!
Wait. He's a train conductor that can't read the time.
No! Sponsor!
Oh man, my VPN isn't fast enough. I wish there was an Express version of it.
ExpressVPN stands for Express Very Personal Information, and it protects your privacy and security on the internet, whether you're gaming online or shopping for the latest single from Peppa Pig.
My bacon sandwich won! None unless you got pork!
While you game online, with ExpressVPN you'll be able to access geo-restricted servers, get early access to games that are launched in different countries, improve latency during a match, or reduce DDoS attacks by encrypting all of your data. And if you aren't a nerd, you can use ExpressVPN to keep every bit of your personal info, from usernames and passwords to credit card information, safe whenever you use public Wi-Fi, which I do all the time whenever I stay in hotels for conventions. Plus, this service has proven to be consistently faster than other VPN providers. Even better, after you get the service on Windows, iOS, Android, and your microwave, all you need to do is pick the best server location for you in 94 different countries and connect up with one click. No joke, a single click and you're completely safe. So take back your internet privacy today and find out how you can get 3 months of the number one rated VPN service by Tech Radar by clicking in the link in the description below or going to expressvpn.com/caddy. Oh look, now we get an even lovelier image of two trains about to collide into each other at full speed. I told you, this show was messed up. Moving on, we now get to click on the poster of Duck, and we have to match the correct halves of this image together, but I'm getting a little bit curious. Can you fail this game? Can you fail Thomas the Tankin' Dankin' on PS1? Well, I got that one wrong, and that one wrong, so apparently not. It just keeps going until you get it right. But you do make Sir Topham Hatt very sad. But I don't know why he's so sad. I mean, if he knows what his own trains look like, then why is he asking me to help him? Oh great, another violent image of train abuse. This time it's a train careening to its inevitable death.
Why are these loading screens in a kid's game? What's this saying to the audience at home? Oh, don't worry kids, next time you're on a train, you might not even be on the rails!
Anyway, now we happen to be done with this screen, so we can scan across to screen number 2. Ooh, looky cookie, more trains. My favourite kind of public transport. I can only assume then this means there's more games, so let's give this one a click.
Konnichiwa!
Hello!
So it looks like Edward is about to join in with the fun. Oh god, what's happening? No, what's going on? What am I doing? Is this a race? Oh man, no time to talk, we're hitting buttons now, hitting buttons! Why is this person's hand so small on the PS1 controller? Is that how I should be doing this? For Christ's sakes, watch out, Thomas, you're about to fly off the track! Oh, no worries, we slowed down, alright. It looks like we won the race.
Hey, do you reckon on the island of Sodor, if a train loses a race against another train, it gets thrown into the scrapyard? I was kidding!
Alright, next minigame. Time to click on Edward's face. I'm really not sure what to make of any of this. Is this another race? I don't know, but the game wants me to pick somebody, so I guess I'll pick Henry, because it looks like he'll kill me if I don't.
Henry slept with my wife.
Oh, wait, no! It was a game where we had to pick the longest engine. Yeah, I totally knew that's what we had to do. I didn't guess that. It only seems appropriate now to click on the Henry's face minigame on the main menu, see where that takes us. And there he is now. Oh man, nice breets. Okay, now we appear to have Duck, Percy, and Edward, but I don't know what to do since all the buttons have stopped working. I've got no prompts, I can't pause or exit. What's going on? Henry, help me! Oh, wait a second. Is this a pick the train that was swapped over game? That makes more sense now. Well, yeah, that's Toby Obvs. And then we get another delightful image for the loading screen.
Thomas has cholera.
Off to the Gordon minigame.
Cholera.
I hate Gordon. My least favorite character. I hated him as a kid and I still hate him today. I mean, look here. He's already angry at me and I haven't even done anything yet. All right, he's about to drown. Well, that makes sense. I suppose I'd be angry about that too. All we need to do is pick the correct track shape to help out Satan incarnate as a train, and away we go. Onto the
James
minigame next, and believe it or not, this was the first minigame I actually got completely wrong. And not because I didn't understand the text or the object of the game, I just had to match the face on the body. But I swear to God, this was Thomas's face. But it was in fact actually Percy's face. What kind of shit is that about? Am I that inept at Thomas the Tankin' Dankin' on the PlayStation?
What do you think the crime rate on Sodor is like?
We get booted back to the main menu, and just when I thought we'd loop back around to the first screen we started on... No way, there's another page of minigames. This is just spoiling me now. We get to explore around the docks for a bit, as it appears, but overall, different verse, same as the first. Well, except for this. We click on the Thomas minigame and it is yet another game I failed miserably at. I can't remember the last time I saw a difficulty curve this steep. Not even joking, I failed so badly at it that I didn't even get a second chance. The game just ended when I got it wrong. Now come on. I like to think I'm a reasonable boy, so when I say this is majorly unfair because this symbol looks like it's telling me to smack the buttons as fast as possible, yet the game punishes you for doing that, would you agree that isn't my fault?
And you can shut up, Honky the Tonk Eagle!
I mean, I cannot be happy with myself if I let Thomas on PS1 beat me, so I'm gonna try again, and this time, I figured out what you're supposed to do. Instead of following the on-screen prompt that babies are definitely going to look at, just ignore that, and hit the button once to start filling Thomas's tank, and then a second time to stop when it reaches the red mark. I do wish that was a little more clear, and by the way, if you don't press the button a second time, Thomas wets himself from his face. Ugh, back to the menu again, and now we have to move on to the cheeky little Bill and Ben flower pot
trains.
What on earth could they possibly have in store? Oh, it's another counting game. Well, I'm pretty pro at them by this point. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, suck on that with your working mouth. Another James mini game is next on the agenda, and you have to pick the correct animals and objects hiding in the trucks he's carrying. Easy enough. and then we get another Sir Topham Hatt minigame.
Yeah!
Well, more accurately, it isn't a game. We in fact get to create our very own train. We get to pick a body, some paint, a face, and even a funnel. Not gonna lie, this is really cool, especially if you were a major Thomas fan back in the day. I made a train called Gerard Way, and he's an angsty young engine full of hatred that nobody understands. And I think his funnel is overcompensating for something. Also, he sounds like this. Or you could always make the ugliest thing imaginable, like this lovely chap. Off to yet another minigame that this time is actually a minigame. So what do we do here? We need to wait for the crane to match with the correct object over the truck and then hit the circle button to drop it in. Pretty difficult stuff. I mean, what else can I say about it other than I get shown yet another image of inhumane train brutality when I'm done?
By the way, the game is still going. I'm actually kind of amazed. I mean, out of all the other toddler games I've played in the past, I wasn't expecting any more than 15 minutes plus of total game time from this, but to my surprise, it just keeps on going. It's got too much love to get. I can't take the love that Thomas the Tank King is danking in me.
We've got yet another page of minigames to do, this time in the quarry. We've got a jigsaw completion game, a match the image against the dirty train game, a memory game when you need to pick the correct train that will reach the station that you saw earlier. Fast and Furious 6, and this game where we control Percy getting chased by falling boulders.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Hell yeah, I'm not gonna touch any buttons, I wanna see what happens. Wait for it, wait for it, wait for it.
Boom!
Ooh. And duck! Oh yes, Percy is down, and then, no! Oh my god, this horrific boulder from one of the scariest episodes of Thomas and Friends appears out of bloody nowhere and traps us on the tracks forever while staring into our very being.
Oh what? You don't know that episode? The one where Rusty is convinced there's a boulder that's deliberately trying to smash him and all of his friends because they're drilling into a mountain it's sat on top of, and the boulder somehow manages to get off the mountain, chase the trains around, roll uphill, get behind Rusty when it was rolling in front of him a second ago, and the episode ends with the Fat Controller suggesting there's a paranormal force living inside the boulder and the boulder has a face! And here's a picture of a dying traction engine!
There's two, there's four, there's six, there's eight.
Oh my god, I can't believe it. There's yet another page of minigames to go through. We start off with this one, with a game that requires basic understanding of Japanese that I clearly really don't have. So I got every single guess wrong and yeah, alright, I think I'm done now. I'm sure you've all got the idea by this point. There is a lot to play with in this game, but as you've seen, a lot of it is exactly the same, or I just don't bloody understand any of it. As we go on, there's some more counting games, more memory games, more correct path games, more creative games like this colouring thing here.
Yatta! Consider!
More mashing button games, more matching games, more correct timing games. What more can I say about each of these games as individual entities anyway? What do you want from me? They're made for babies, I can't add anything else. Besides, the animal noises distort the audio levels.
Saying that though, consider me surprisingly impressed. Yeah. Consider me surprisingly impressed with this mother chugger. I mean, yeah, it's simplistic and way too easy for any kids over the age of 2, but when I think back to other games I've played in the past that are meant for kids, especially games that are made for a slightly older audience, like tweenies game time, this is better in pretty much every single way, and this was meant for an older audience.
The graphics and music are much better done and way more appealing. There's a crap ton more minigames to play with and things to see and discover. When replaying certain minigames, they actually change aspects of it so it isn't the same exact thing twice to keep it interesting for kids on replays. And even though it's all in Japanese, it's that accessible and understandable that even I could play it without any Japanese knowledge whatsoever. Helped along by the fact that you never use a D-pad, only the face buttons. And in fact, when this game first came out, it even came bundled with a specifically designed giant button pad so the extremely young children this was aimed at couldn't possibly get it wrong. And it was wipeable, in case Thomas made them sick. I mean, look, in the menus for this game, you even get tiny little character biographies. I can't fault this game for the target audience. It's adorable. Well, I mean, I assume they're character biographies. They could be eulogies for all I know.
The next question is, why was it Japanese exclusive? Because I really don't know. Oh, brother, is that the time? I'm eating.
Percy!
Just look what you've done to our breakfast. Now I shall have to cook some more. She banged the door.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. Sorry for the hair. It's swept back, it's sweaty, it's greasy. I've been drumming. It won't happen again. There will be outtakes at the very end of this video, so please stay tuned. And there will be outtakes not just from myself, but from the lovely and the brilliant TomSka. Thank you so much, dude, for appearing in...
And here's a pic. Jesus.
You think that's cool? You should see my short, stumpy dog. Nail it. Here to give you...
Alex Van Kirk, thank you so much, every single one of you amazing people.
So he sent me here to give you one of
the... And here's a pic... Jesus.
Jesus,
dude. You think that's cool? You should see my short, stumpy dome.
Perfect for a kid's...
Can't you see? I'm TomSka, the tank person.
Is the mirror here going to be a problem?
Shouldn't be.
It shouldn't be.
Ben's
in the
reflection.
Well, he is right there.
How are you?
Yeah.
Hey, what's up?
This is going in the video. This was not planned, but it's too
you
good.
You broke our door.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah, it's
look
gone.
What you've done to our door.
Look what you've done to our front door.
No, wait, don't go, Caddicarus. No, wait, don't go, youtube.com/CaddicarusTV.
That's not the name.
I forgot.
No, wait, don't go.
Did you guys know that Thomas the Tank Engine had a PS1 game exclusive to Japan?
No.
Yeah, I knew that.
Boop, boop. So did I.
You get out of here.
I was gonna say, like, for the mailbox slot, just slap some super glue on there, man. It'd be all good. Like, just let it sit dry. Be all good, man. That's all you gotta do. Yeah, that was hilarious. Anyway, that's my reaction to Old Thomas the Tank Engine on PS1 by Caddicarus, featuring Ska. No, TomSka. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.